Hey, just a heads up, tomorrow we launch a new Kickstarter for a novel that Bones has written called Honey Walls. It is about a trans man going on a quest to get his heart back and save his mermaid girlfriend. It's a really great book. I've read it. I think it's really heartwarming and sweet and fun and whimsical. There's sock animals and a little fox lawyer. It's great. It's a really good book. Highly recommend. And yeah, we're going to be starting the Kickstarter campaign tomorrow. It's going to be illustrated by an illustrator named Alex Dingley. And it's going to be narrated into an audiobook by Jonathan Coventry. And I'm very excited. So go check it out tomorrow. We will publicize it quite a bit. So yeah, see you then, fam. On to the video. Also, I'm very sorry for the quality of this video recording. Bones and I have been doing our recordings during our Twitch streams on Wednesday nights. It was our first time trying to record footage as well as stream, and we didn't get the settings right, so the quality is a little low, but hopefully it's still viewable. So, sorry about that. It'll be better next time. More pencils! Yay! Okay, these are taking longer than I expected, as usual. Like anything in this heckin' project. I definitely think I need to allow myself to take it slow. I'm definitely nervous about these taking a while, but I think once my schedule is a little bit more free, I'll be able to zoom through these pages a lot more and get a lot more work done. I think right now I'm just juggling a lot of projects, like I'm doing a piece for an anthology and working on Magpie and this and getting ready for our Kickstarter. Just things have been a little crazy, and there's also some stressful life stuff going on right now. So yeah, once things have settled down, hopefully I can get through these a lot quicker. But for now, I'll just finish maybe one or two pages every drawing session. That's not bad. If I keep at that like every day, that's a good amount. So even though these have been going kind of slow for now, and honestly, I really think they're going slow just because I haven't spent too much time on them, like not a lot of drawing sessions on them. But like, despite the speed of how these are going, the compositions are looking good. I'm really happy with them. I like how things are laid out. I like how dynamic everything feels. It's been really easy to pencil these pages. I mean, outside of like, you know, making sure the characters are on model and making sure that there's like a good structure beneath everything, I haven't had to worry about the composition part of it at all. Whereas I find working on, say, like Magpie or other comic projects where I haven't done all this planning, there are some times where I'll finish penciling and then I'll look at the page and go like, oh, that panel wasn't, the composition kind of sucks, let me redo this. Whereas this, when I finish a page, I'm like, oh, this looks great. The composition is readable, it looks really dynamic, I like it. And that's a really good feeling, because it's not like, it doesn't feel like guesswork. It just kind of feels like tightening things up. Also, having these all laid out, I've kind of been playing with the idea of adding in sound effects. I don't really have any sound effects in Magpie, or I don't think they're very present in Pretty Mouth either. I use them a lot in Sovereign, but like not consistently. I think at the beginning of Sovereign, there was quite a few sound effects. And whenever there was like a really necessary one, I'd put it in. But in most of my comics, I don't really utilize sound effects. And I think they're great in comics. I'm always really happy when I find a comic that uses sound effects really well. I think it really adds to the atmosphere. So I've been toying with the idea of using them in 9-point, and I think having all this prep work done, it's a little easier to stop when I'm penciling and go like, yeah, I could put a sound effect here, let's see how this works. So I'm gonna keep playing around with them and see how I feel. I don't know if I'll be able to stay like consistent with these, but I can try my best. I mean, if I don't like them, I can always take them out before I finish the pages. Who knows? Maybe they'll look good, maybe they won't. I'm curious, do you guys use like sound effects in your comics? They're definitely something I was kind of blind to for a long time. Well, I think part of it, was like I grew up reading manga, and not every single manga I would read would have the sound effects translated, like just depending on what publisher you were reading, or if you were reading like a stolen scan version online. Like, not all the sound effects would be remade to be in English. So, like, I would see them, and they would really look nice for the composition, but either they'd have, like, English text just kind of, like, off in the corner, or they wouldn't be translated at all. So I didn't see them a lot when I was first getting into comics, but reading, say, web comics and more like Western style comics, I definitely started seeing them more and being more interested in them. And depending on, like, sometimes I'd find like a manga that they went through and they switched up all the sound effects and translated them. But yeah, it's always been something that I've been kind of blind to, and it's really, oh my god, my voice is going. But it's been very cool to think about them again, because they are really fun. You can do a lot with sound effects. You can, like I said, it adds to the atmosphere. You can make, say, an action feel really real and grounded when it has, like, a sound to it. They can be used for visual effect. Like, if they're in the composition, they can, you know, add to it and lead the eye around the page. It's just another tool and aspect of that. Just like speech bubbles or characters or backgrounds, how they all feed into that as well. And yeah, and they can be funny. They can be intense. They can, there's lots of versatility, and I really want to explore that more. But like I said, this has just been kind of a snap decision recently. So who knows if I'll stick with it, but I think if I commit to putting in sound effects, I have to do it for the rest of 9 Point. And if I don't want to commit to it, I guess I shouldn't include them. I'll play around. Who knows? I'm still in the draft work stage, so this is, like, where I can actually sit down and experiment with these things instead of worrying about it at the very end when I'm inking. One thing I definitely need to do is I need to make sure that I have my character models open at all times, and probably the script as well when I'm working on these. I'm pretty, like, I know what happens in the script here. Like, because I drew it, I've read it over so many times that I have, like, a good understanding of what happens here, but, like, sometimes I can forget the exact wording, or maybe in my thumbnails I wasn't super clear about the emotion, so it's probably a good idea to have my script open just to make sure I don't put the wrong emotion in the wrong place or something. I don't know. It's good practice to keep it open. I don't always do it. Mostly because it's like, it can just be like a screen space issue, or sometimes I won't have my second monitor facing me with the script open, or I won't always have the printed version of the script with me. I need to do that more and just deal with it not being how I usually draw. Just because I have a setup that I like and I don't want to change it, so but I should, just so that I can see my script. And same goes with character model sheets. I noticed a few times where I was like, I don't really know if this looks like marble, or I don't know if this looks like ember. So if I just have their character sheets open, I can just double check that I'm keeping my characters on model, and that's really important. And I made those character sheets, so I should use them. I put so much work into those. I should make use of the heckin' resources that I made. So from now on, I'm gonna make sure that I have my character sheets open, and my scenery layouts open, and my script, just so that I'm well prepared and I don't let all my hard work go to waste. But yeah, penciling is always fun. It's one of my favorite parts of the process. Personally, I really like to keep my penciling fast and loose. It's definitely helped to have these really detailed thumbnails underneath, because it definitely gives me a better foundation for my pencils. So I find I can be a lot more confident with kind of where I'm placing my lines and where I'm focusing my attention, instead of, because I find when I work off a thumbnail that is super, super undefined, like if it's just a stick figure, which is a little different than what I've done here, which is very, like, a much more built out thumbnail. When I'm working off one that is super, like, low detail, I can get kind of lost in structuring out my stuff. So, like, figuring out the anatomy or the proportions or the form of the character, like, I can get really stuck on that, and my pencils will be really stiff because of that. And then usually I'll have to do a few more layers of, like, penciling and going over it over and over again to get it to look nice. But having these really structured thumbnails has kind of helped with focusing on just the pencil work instead of all the structure work. But it's very important to keep that structure work in my penciling stuff. And there's been a few times where I've had to go back and redo different panels because the structure wasn't right or something looked off. It's a balance and it's a struggle, but it definitely helps having these detailed layouts underneath. I also know that, like, with my pencils, I'm very quick and loose. Like, I know I spent the front half of this video, like, complaining about how I'm not going fast enough, but I do know that I'm very fast with my pencils. And I like it that way because I think the inking stage, I guess in 9 Points case, like, the flat coloring and rendering stage, because I'm not doing inks for it. I think the inking stage is where the detail work comes in for me. And I think that's where, I guess, like, everything comes together. I know lots of people do, like, really detailed pencil work, especially when they're handing it off to someone else to do the inks. But I find that, like, the more loose and gestural I leave it, the more motion my inks have. I mean, I definitely will go too far often and have my inks be really messy. But I think keeping my pencils loose and then tightening my inks up really helps a lot. Because if you have stiff pencils, you're not going to have fluid inks. I mean, I guess that's just how my process works. So I zoom through and I keep it pretty loose, and that's what works for me. But yeah, it's really nice to be going over these over and over again, and each layer is just getting more detailed and more structured, and it's all feeling better, like, the further I go into these pages, so that's really nice. I mean, just looking at the thumbnails that I did previously, like, I'm really happy with how these pages are gonna look. Like, even at really low res, tiny versions, they still look nice. So I'm very excited, and I'm excited to see that they're just getting better as they go along. Wow, my voice is feeling really scratchy. I don't know what's going on here. So yeah, like I mentioned earlier, Bones and I have been streaming on Twitch a lot. This week we did 2 art streams in the evening. Bones does, like, a work stream in the middle of the day, Tuesdays and Thursdays right now. But we've been doing art streams on Wednesday nights, and we did one this past Friday night, though I don't know if we're going to continue doing that. We just felt bad because we knew we weren't going to be streaming yesterday on Saturday. Because we were going to go see family for Easter, like an early Easter celebration. So, yeah, so we were like, let's get an extra stream in, maybe we can record some footage. That's kind of what we've been trying to do with the Wednesday streams as of the past, like, 2 weeks, 1 week. We've been trying to get all of our video recording done, like, not the audio, but the visuals done, just so that I have a little more time during the week to work on other projects and maybe getting ahead on some of my footage. Because a lot of the time it gets left to the last minute and I get stressed out when it's like, well, I can't do any footage artwork tonight because I have to stream on Twitch or the YouTube stream or whatever. And it can just, you know, makes me anxious. And I talked about that on the last vlog. But yeah, so we tried it. It went really well. It was really nice to just have one night where I get all my footage done and get my audio done early. I mean, I didn't do the audio on stream, but doing it elsewhere really helped, and having it done early really helped. Yeah, so I think we're going to continue doing that. So I guess make sure to check out Twitch on Wednesday evenings, 8 p.m. EST. If you want to hang out and talk to us while we draw. It's also really nice because I really like streaming. It's a really nice way to like, talk to you guys and interact with you guys. And it's really fun. Yeah, I'm just happy that it's making my workload a little easier and I still get to stream and talk to you guys. Yeah, and like I said, I'm sorry that we missed the stream on Saturday. I feel bad because that's definitely one of my, like, favorite things to do. I really, really like those streams. They're really fun. But yeah, like I said, we were out of town seeing Bones's family. Like, as much as I'm sad we missed the stream, it was also kind of nice to just chill and hang out with family. And it was nice to just have this weekend to relax. And yeah, so, but we'll be back next weekend and it'll all be good. So don't worry, nothing's changing there. It was just a day off, I guess. Yeah, and yeah, it's been nice to relax this past weekend because this past week was kind of stressful. Like I mentioned in my Thursday video, I'm doing some doctor stuff right now, and it has been stressful and icky, and I thought I was good with doctor procedures, but I've discovered that I am not good with them at all. And I have a few more appointments coming up soon, so I'm not super happy about that, but I'll survive. It'll be good. I've got my art, I've got bones, I've got my pets, so life is good. Fado is sleeping on a little bed and looking at me as I record. Normally he's running around being crazy because I do these like in the middle of the afternoon, but I'm doing it at like 11 o'clock at night. So yeah, he's just sleeping and being a sweetie. Oh, also Bones got a Roomba and he's really excited. So yeah. And he's also excited about the Kickstarter. I can't believe that's happening tomorrow. That's pretty crazy. But I'm excited because I really want to see Honeywalls get funded and be a book that's in people's hands. Bones has been working on it for like a few years now, and it's a really great story, and I really love it. And I know that it is something that is very close to his heart. So yeah, I hope you guys check it out. Thank you for watching this. Thanks for being cool, I guess. I hope everyone is having a good time with their comics and making lots of progress. And if you're not making lots of progress, then I hope you're still having fun or relaxing and just having a good time and enjoying your artwork, because that's all that matters. You know, you can only get as much done as you can get done, and you should have fun while you're making stuff, because comics are a lot of fun. Learning art stuff is fun. So yeah, I wish you all the best, and I'll see you guys next time. Yeah. Goodbye.